We're going to get Patrice O'Neill a two-hour relationship show.
You're never going to meet a girl whose hymen ain't broken.
You mumble-mouthed, fat-tongued mongoloid.
It's the whole truth.
People are calling you the Black Dr. Phil.
With Patrice O'Neill.
Bad, like, retard teeth.
Fuck me! Love me! Feed me! That's what you do!
I wanted to bite his face when he said that
dopey smile.
I'm a good man.
Shut up.
I have never fucked once to the song. Like, you don't know what me and my girl fucked to? Independent films on, like, Encore. Like, we fucked to anything. Like, we fucked to last night. We fucked to, what was on TV we fucked to? We fucked to, oh my god, what the fuck was that? It was something obscure, like I heard gunshots or a train crash and shit, and we just humping, spitting each other's face, and choking each other, with love, of course. And then, what the fuck was, what was the moment, we was fucking to something that you shouldn't fuck to, but like, I never, like, these songs, like, oh baby, oh, this is so romantic. How do you shove a bitch's head against the wall to this? It almost makes you feel guilty. You gotta fuck a bitch to, like, highlights from the NHL. Oh, look at them motherfuckers fighting. Oh, come here, baby. Come here. We had a good session last night, I thought. I did something bad to her tongue. I actually gave her tongue a hickey. It's weird. I got nervous. You ever fuck, right? Welcome to the Black Phillip. You ever fuck and just do something horrible to your girl, and afterwards you just go, oh my god, what I, like, during the shit, you're like, ah, you know, and then afterwards you're like, oh my god, what did I? Like, you get nervous, like, you go, oh my, should we go to the hospital? I gave my girl's tongue a hickey, like, it bust a blood vessel in the tongue, is that, we were sucking on it. Because we have good fuck sessions when I buy her something, like, when I don't like her is when we fuck the best. Like, when she makes me sick, you know what I mean? And it's like, we haven't fucked for, like, 2 weeks, right? And then after the second week, then I go, okay, I buy her something. Like, say she was on a period, and then we didn't fuck for whatever reason. Then I, like, buy her, like, a fucking, you know, a couple of shoes or some clothes and shit. And then I, like, you bitch. Like, I look at her like, you fucking bitch.
Then you're angry.
Bitch. Exactly, right. And then, you know.
Sex.
And then, you know, when they're happy, you know that happy look they have when you buy them something? Like, that appreciative look? And you go, don't thank me, bitch, for your, don't. Thank me? What the fuck are you looking at? Come here.
Yeah, just,
and you just want to fuck, you know, let me ask you something, Kathleen. How do you relate to that? Have you ever bought a man something so expensive?
No.
That you actually, like, were mad about it, that you bought it? But you wanted to buy it, but you was angry that you fucking bought it.
I don't think so, no. Never anything that,
so how can you
that
relate?
Made me mad.
You don't relate. You just kind of.
I can relate to angry sex, definitely, but not because I bought somebody something. That doesn't make me mad.
Hold on, let me introduce the show for a second, and then I'm gonna goddamn get to you and your horseshit. Hi, Puddin'. My girl's sitting in here in the studio, by the way.
With her.
And Kathleen was like, "That's the Kathleen goes. That's your girlfriend? She's very sexy. I think Kathleen wants a piece of my girl.
She's hot.
She is, but what would your retarded ass do with her? She's very fucking,
She's very, you know, advanced in the fuck department.
Oh, well, that's good.
I can went here. I would like. What would you do in terms of a threesome? Oh, I'm gonna get to that. Hold on, Kathleen. I'd like to know what the fuck your part in a threesome would be. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Black Phillip Show with Patrice O'Neill, Kathleen Rowe, and Dante Nero's a little late. Traffic in New York and fucking rain. I'm winding down because I was like on the way here to like, you know, I was on the way here through the fucking rain, through the fucking Arab cab drivers, through the shitty livery cabs. So I'm like all angry and I got to settle down and get into like Black Phillip mode. But welcome to the show. And those who've never listened before, it's a relationship show. But let me explain what the relationship part is. It's not to say, hey, man, you should. It's not to save relationships. It's to dig deep into the original. We're trying to go all the way back to where relationships began and fix it from there. We're trying to fix it from the Sphinx, or not the Sphinx, not the asshole. We're not trying to fix it from the sphincter. We're trying to go all the way back to when it began so that we could recondition. Like, mostly reconditioned bitches. But in there, we're trying to help guys also. We're trying to help guys to teach their women how to fucking have another option, another way to think, another direction to go into. So this show is not to go, hey, maybe y'all should go out to the movies, and maybe... No, none of that shit. All right? So welcome to the show. Kathleen Rowe, of course, my co-host. Dante Nero is a little late, but he'll fucking...
Probably on his way. You took a cab from Jersey?
No.
Oh, okay.
What was I going to say? I said something I wanted to say about the show, too. I forgot. Anyway, welcome.
The angry sex.
Angry sex? Fuck angry sex. I want to know, have you ever done a threesome? By the way, phone lines, if you want to call in, you know, whatever, it's 1-866... Wow, one, wow. Is that the correct number? 866, wow, one, wow. And I don't have the number in front of me to tell you what the numbers are, because I know a lot of you motherfuckers are retarded, but I'll give you the numbers soon. And I'm glad you're here. If you're in New York City, this is a good night to sit there and listen. It's a rainy night. Fellas, I know you. This is a good night. You canceled that bullshit date that you wanted to go out with on your girl because she's like, we never go nowhere and we don't do nothing. And then you're like, oh my God, thank God it fucking rained. So you can go, sweetie, your hair is nice. You don't want to go out in the rain like that. Blah, 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 blah. This is my shitty attempt to, Oh, Dante needs somebody to go get him. Okay. 866-969-1969. That's 866-969-1969. So let me ask you something, Kathleen.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
Let me ask you something. Have you ever had a threesome, first of all?
I have never had a threesome.
All right.
No.
What would you think? And this is a woman's thought on what a threesome would be that never had one. All right? Mm-hmm. What do you think that your role would be in a threesome? Okay, ready? In two ways. One, the other bitch. Like,
yeah.
you're not the girlfriend.
Okay, if I was the other woman.
And second, if you was the woman. So first, focus on if you wasn't the girl. If you was the side bitch coming in to fuck a couple.
I would assume if you were the secondary player, you would not. The guy would not penetrate you. You would have sex with the woman, possibly oral. Like, you would be there to be with the woman, and the guy would like the visual thing, and the woman probably would like your oral skills. Do you see what I'm saying? That's like, if you were to, that's, well, I'm answering your
this
question.
This is why?
Logistically, that's what I would assume.
What would you do if you was just, okay, me and my girl was fucking, right?
Right,
and we just
right.
decided we're going to fuck on this table. What would you do to join in? What would you do?
I don't think I'd join in. I'd watch.
No, you
I
was definitely first of all hypothetical. Welcome, first of all, Dante. What's up, man?
What's up,
Dante, is it traffic and all that bullshit?
Yeah,
it's goofy, right?
Yeah.
All right, Dante Nero, my other co-host is here today, and oh, how you doing, Pumpkin? Fucking E-Rock came in, all like with that desperate look, like, oh shit, it's gonna fall apart. I'm late. Nobody needs you, fathead. But I don't want to say that to you because they abuse you all day on the fucking show. So I'm glad you're here, nigga. Thank you. Wind down, please. We're all winding down. So wait a minute. Yeah. I'm talking hypothetically. Hypothetically. What if you had to join in? What's the first thing you would do?
Think as nasty
as you can.
Start making out with me first.
Yeah, I'd make out with Dante.
Listen to me. What would you do if you had to be in a fucking threesome?
I would assume if you're with your girlfriend...
Stop assuming, Kathleen! Woman. Listen, stop assuming. No assuming. You are...
Okay.
In time and space, you are definitely in this threesome. You are... It's ante up time, bitch. You are ready. You gotta fuck. You gotta be in this mix.
Okay,
What would you do?
So I absolutely have to do.
Yes.
Like I have a gun.
Do you see why guys don't like you? And I don't mean you, Kathleen. I mean bitches. Cause you fucking don't know how to have fun with a hypothetical question.
Oh, okay.
You're like, now you're saying, I'm being raped in this hypothetical thing because I don't want to.
Right,
and
right.
Don't. Let's assume that you want to. Let's assume that you fucking are going to. Let's assume that this is going down under your complete and utter fucking... You condone it.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine, Patrice.
What would you do?
I would go for her. I'm just... This is another assumption.
Just say
it. She smells better than you. Probably. Maybe.
Well, why would you think that?
I don't know. It's
fat?
Just...
Well, because I'm a guy. Guys, women smell better than fat.
Yeah, right. Because I'm unfamiliar with both of you.
Right.
But just,
how
unfucking
fun are you? Can you just pretend AIDS doesn't exist either? Can you just, what would you do? What would you do? Would you do anything?
What do you want me to say?
I want you to just get into...
breast. You want, you
whoa,
want,
yeah,
like,
there you go.
Language.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Who knows? I'd fondle her breasts. Is that what you want me to say?
Fondle? You know what my girl would do if you fondled her? She would knee you in your in the bridge of your fucking nose.
I'd pull her hair and sit on her face. How's that?
That would be pretty good.
But now we got to figure out how do you smell? Because I got money that Kathleen's pussy looks like a
70s Woodstock.
I can't imagine that you shave your pussy.
My pussy is... I trim.
I guarantee
it's spring
hairy.
Fresh. It's spring fresh.
Well, of course, it's because
why would my pussy be hairy? I'm not.
You just seem like you would have a hairy pussy. To
like I'd be, natural.
Yeah, like you would just go why? Like you read a book about shaving. It's like, you know, when you shave, you get a thing called, you know, labiitis.
Well, the opposite is true. It's better It's better to shave for cleanliness. Like, that's when they operate, they shave you.
Mm-hmm.
Hair carries dirt. So.
Oh, really? It's trimmed up?
Yeah. Mm. Definitely.
Oh, I bet you fucking Kathleen is the worst ever.
It's hot.
Just can't imagine that it could be possibly interesting. I swear to goodness. Would you do my
You'd
girl?
Be surprised.
Fucking no, I wouldn't.
Oh, yeah.
No, the fuck, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, I can't. Well, I can't imagine you. I imagine you, Patrice, like you just grunt a few times in the neck. Like I could. I can't imagine you doing anything.
Now, let me see. Does a bitch like that looks like her, right? Now, my girl's in the studio for people who just not listening. Now, you think a bitch that looks like that would just be...
She's really hot.
Would really like a motherfucker to be grunting on top of her?
I don't think that she would, but it's probably not... That's not what attracts you to her.
Attracts... Yeah, it is, actually.
Her to you.
Yeah, it is, sexually.
That
believe
you're hot
it.
In
I,
bed?
I am
no,
the sexual object in the relationship.
Really?
Ask the bitch. She's sitting right in front of you.
I could... Yeah, right. I'm not even going to ask her. I could look at her face and know that that's not true.
She's looking at you like she wants to fuck you up for saying what you're saying. You are the dumbest smart bitch I've ever fucking heard.
You're sexier than she is. Is that what you're trying to tell me?
No. I know more about fucking than she knows about fucking. You understand what I'm saying? So the fact that I know more about fucking than her...
Really?
Means that I'm going to be the sexier one because she's not going to introduce anything to me. I'm going to introduce something to her.
Yeah.
You understand? Like,
I do understand.
Physically, she beats me 95 times out of 95 and a half. You know, unless I'm in some fucking cold country where, you know, fat people are deemed... like I'm like you like Oonga Boonga Boonga,
like the golden cow,
the fat Boonga. You are sexy.
Yeah, but you're in a gay bar in India.
But yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, if you was to give me some pussy, you would then know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you was to give me some pussy,
I would see you.
It's not about good. It's just be about like, cause you'll go.
It's about filth.
Like, you are a person that I know that, and there's a lot of women like that who would be like.
She needs direction. Kathleen likes a man, somebody who's gonna direct the
you
flow
think
of
so?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
First of all, all
of
women,
all, Dante,
all
that's,
women,
that's redundant.
All women like that. They
that's
just don't know.
Because you're gonna be
they
the type of chick
know
that's gonna go, I don't like that, and I don't like this,
shut your
and
mouth.
I don't want to do that, and I don't want to. It's like, don't pull
you'd
my hair.
Surprised.
I won't be surprised.
The reason why I think she's sexy.
Kathleen, are you filthy?
Because your perceptions are just way off.
Are you filthy?
Insane?
Kathleen, you filthy?
No, she's not.
No.
That's
no.
What, so automatically that says you're bad
you
in
little
bed.
Prudish?
Yeah.
Well, how
are you filthy
you,
or
so
you,
what,
you
wait
prudish?
A minute, Dante. Wait a minute. What would anybody be surprised with if you're saying that you're a prude in bed and you're not filthy? What am I going to be surprised that you're going to do? What are you going to give me a great spot where
I
massages?
Did, I did not say I was
ice
a
in a mouth.
In bed.
Oh, yeah.
Peppermint.
I did not say I was
Mentos
a prude
in my
bed.
Mouth. You're goofy. Hold on. Wait a minute. We're going to talk to Schmitty real quick. It's Schmitty.
Yeah, what's up?
What's going on?
About, with Kathleen and all, I was remembering the first time I had sex with my wife, and my friend and I thought about having a three-way. You know, my wife is in town and whatnot, and we get that back to the house. We have a couple drinks. We get down to it, this, that, the other thing. The girls eat my wife's pussy, or future wife's pussy.
Mm.
Suck my dick. Mm. Go have at it. Girls got a fucking outbreak of herpes.
Who got an outbreak of herpes?
The friend, not my future wife.
I was
curious if maybe Kathleen had a little herpes outbreak. That's why she wouldn't want penetration.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You lost weight.
Who had the outbreak?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What?
Who got the outbreak?
I had a friend, and then so we met my wife.
Guy or girl?
Girl.
Okay.
There was two girls.
Oh, wait.
Girl.
Hold up, Schmitty. Let me explain something to anybody who's listening. All right? When you say threesome, understand that a threesome is two girls and a guy. You have to be very specific. Two guys and a girl. You understand? So never forget that terminology. So we won't have to ask anybody when they say threesome or menage a trois, that's two girls and one guy. Or more girls than a... Well, then it's an orgy. But two guys and a girl is a train, okay? All right, go ahead. So who had the herpes?
The girl.
The friend.
The girl.
She had an outbreak of herpes.
Yes. And she... I'm like, hey, let's... let's have fun with this new girl over here. And she's like, all right. So we get back. She's licking my future wife's pussy.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're getting into it. I'm fucking throwing some porn on for them, you know, getting them in the mood, you know. I'm like, all right, let them lick a little pussy and stuff like that.
Okay.
So then eventually, you know, I freaking whip my cock out, stick it in my future wife's mouth. She's into it.
This nigga's worried he got herpes. When this happened? Yesterday?
No, I didn't know.
when did shit happen, nigga? Tell
the
truth.
I didn't get no herpes, dude. It was on... It was
wait a minute. Don't get defensive.
Wait.
Dirty dick motherfucker. Don't get mad at me, nigga.
This guy's deluded.
Wait a second.
He's not facing facts. Your wife has herpes. Is that what you're saying?
The girl had herpes.
Oh, no. Ex-girls.
Hold on. Stop the presses. Stop for a minute. Okay. Let me explain. You tell me when I'm wrong. You're fucking a girl who you find out hindsight 2020 wise has herpes after you and her and your wife had a little threesome.
No, during. Well, ask him, but I think he said during the threesome he finds out she had a herpes breakout and that's why she didn't want any penetration. Is that right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
What? Wait, that don't even sound right.
What
during?
An idiot.
Wait, during the fucking.
No, she was eating his wife's pussy.
You wanted to fuck her, but she's like, no, I got herpes.
Exactly.
So then the threesome stopped, I hope. Did you keep going, you filthy bastard?
What
that's an
idiot.
Extreme.
Yes, I kept going. I kept going on the clean one.
On his wife.
But did you see
the herpes? What did it look like?
I didn't want to look.
Kathleen, I'm gonna tell you something.
This ready? Guy's
I'm gonna tell. Wait a minute. Stop, Schmitty. Hold on, Kathleen. I'm telling you, I'm gonna put you on timeout. if you ask another impertinent, stupid question to what the fuck did it look like? I'm gonna tell you what you're doing. You feel like you need.
I think this.
Kathleen, are you drunk? Kathleen,
shut up.
Why are you fucking like asking these type
There's
of questions?
Something wrong with this story.
We're gonna dig
Someone's
it in.
Someone's not telling the truth. Either what? It's this guy
Kathleen.
Or one of these women.
What's going on?
That's why
Kathleen.
I'm asking the question.
Is what did the herpes look like?
Yeah. Yeah.
How would that get him to expose what the fuck is really going on?
It could have been.
All right, ready? Hey, dude, what did the herpes look like?
Well, after bullshit. I didn't freaking look.
Right. It's like, wait a minute.
Somebody
says
she could be lying, is what I'm getting at.
Yeah, but
she could be lying.
If somebody says I got herpes,
she's
you just assume that they do. It's not like something
you. She doesn't want the guy to.
Okay. Hold on. Wait a second. This is how fucking retarded. This is what I. All right. Listen. If you wanted to be involved in something, right, but only a little bit, wouldn't you say, oh, you know, I'm on my period, if you just wanted to eat pussy and not get fucked, why would you say,
I have
AIDS just of the pussy? Does that make sense to you, Kathleen?
Maybe that's not enough.
Would that be what?
To have sex. And by the way, having sex on your period is the best time for a woman. Your hormones.
Patrice, you got my point. Thank you very much.
Listen, folks, we've been off. Thanks, Smitty. Listen, folks, we've been off for like, I don't even know, a month. When's the last time we was in this motherfucker? A month and some change. All right, we got to get a flow going again. We was going getting a flow. I think Kathleen came in. I think
I didn't hear that guy. Just got my ear.
Look, she won't shut up. She just won't shut up. Kathleen won't shut up today. Like she refuses to shut up. So she made a conscious decision. I'm telling you what happened with Kathleen. She made a conscious decision that she's gonna get in. Like she's gonna talk. She's not gonna be overrun by guys. Somebody got to you. Somebody got to you. Yeah, one of these stupid bitches that do comedy said that you're not talking enough. You read some message board that said something. You changed right now. I see it. Cause you won't shut up. I feel it. Yeah, I feel it. I'm telling you, Kathleen, you think you're not a girl, but you're a girl. I'm feeling you right now.
Because
you won't shut the fuck up, and you keep saying shit that has nothing to do with nothing. Like, we're talking about this herpes guy. I've never heard a caller actually hang up on his own. Like, fuck it. Because you're going, you know, sex on your period, by the way, is meh. Who gives a fuck? Listen to me. Let me direct you. Kathleen, you're very defiant, but I'm going to direct you on even how and when to talk about something that's pertinent. Saying that you fucking like fucking on your period. Wait a minute. I see it on your face. You're not even listening right now. You're super duper defiant today. What happened? Did you got a new boyfriend? Did a new boyfriend give you some fucking confidence out there in the world?
This guy was either lying, the girl was lying to him. The whole scenario
about
was bullshit.
About what?
The whole herpes, his future wife, and
but
whatever.
Why,
it was all
what
bullshit.
About what you were saying?
What about the
wait,
herpes?
What
did
about
it look like?
What about what you were saying made any difference to finding that out?
If she did have herpes,
okay.
He would notice it even before she took off her underwear.
Okay, explain that. That's interesting. Okay, go ahead. Explain how that happens.
Yeah, because it's. Look it up on the internet.
No, I'm not looking up fucking nothing on the internet. You tell us.
I'm saying that I believe this girl was lying to
him.
No.
You
just didn't want to have sex with him.
Hold on, time out. I'm going to let Dante handle this because this bitch is frustrating me because Dante is really a good cop on a lot of shit. she's frustrated because I know something's different about Kathleen. I'm going to find out the bitch is drunk or something. Something's going on with Kathleen. I'm going to get to the callers in a minute, man.
Focus,
okay,
focus
Kathleen,
on the... Wait,
I'm not talking to
Kathleen.
You. I
okay.
To talk.
I'm telling
okay,
you,
wait,
the guy
wait,
pissed me
wait,
off.
Okay.
All I could hear was, oh, maybe Kathleen has herpes. You're an idiot, Smitty. Neither of these women like having sex with you.
Kathleen, there's a you just said he would know that she had herpes before.
Yes,
why?
He would be
see
it.
Where would he see it? How would he see it?
If she had her clothes off, which I assume
Kathleen's
she did,
on timeout for
happy.
A half hour.
She didn't say he had it. How would she see? Could you?
Kathleen's
could
on timeout for a half hour.
Have you ever seen herpes?
I've never seen herpes. That's why I'm asking you. Stop. Just answer the question. What would he have seen that would let him know that she has herpes? What if she wasn't undressed? What if she was just eating his wife's pussy with her clothes on? How would she have known that
okay,
she had herpes?
Fine. Maybe the woman had herpes, but I would assume that she would know that before she went in. If she had herpes, why would she enter into a threesome?
Maybe she wanted to eat pussy.
That's my point. I think she wanted to be with the woman and not right. with this guy.
I don't know if you want to leave, Kathleen, but I am banishing her from the room for about a half hour. A half hour. About a half hour. Just a half. Just for her to get her shit together. Just for her to take a deep breath, because something's going on with Kathleen, and she's evading questions, even simple questions. Like, she's not focused. She's not focused. I feel you. I feel you, Kathleen. I see you.
I don't understand what you find so...
I find that right now, right, you're so combative. I'm a professional at this shit, and I appreciate you being like this. I don't want a quiet little... I like a fight. But I can tell right now you are so, like, on some shit that I'm not positively sure what it is, but you're not going to share it because look at, even before I finish, you've distanced yourself from what's coming out of my mouth, and you're going to say something that has nothing to do with what I just said. You're going to do that. Look at your face. Like, you're disagreeing with me, but you have no disagreement. Like, you're just being like that. What happened to you? Did you get raped over the weekend, bitch? Did something happen?
No.
Patrice, what happened to you this weekend?
I honestly
what the
think
fuck
that this
happened
guy,
to you?
Smitty...
This bitch is crazy. We have left Smitty. We're talking about you, bitch. We're talking about... Do you see what the fuck I'm telling... This
Easy
is the
breath,
shit...
Pat.
This
Pat.
Is the shit bitches
Easy
do.
Breath.
You know what, everybody? Don't get fucking frustrated. This is perfect. This is what you fucking do. You
okay,
you
Patrice.
Talk, you yap, and then when you're talking to your man, ladies, wait, Kathleen, are you in control of this fucking talk button? Click her fucking talk button off, please. Thank you. This is what, ladies, this is what you fucking do. This is what you fucking do. You get in, this is men's fault, fellas. You listen too. They get into this mode, right, where shit comes out of their fucking mouth, and it makes no sense to nobody but them. But the fact that we, all these fucking years, man, that we let them yap like, bah, 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 that's what she sounds like. This guy's going, what the fuck are you talking about, bitch? And you know something else? There's some girl saying it too, listening to her. That's what your man's saying to you, bitch, when you talk about nothing and go blah, 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 blah. We left Smitty 20 hours ago, and this bitch is still talking about her point is to prove Smitty. Nigga, the point is the herpes. What the fuck happened once he found out the herpes? That's the point. That's the point that every guy wants to hear. Every guy goes,
herpes.
Wait, whoa.
Hold up.
You fucking bitches with herpes, nigga? That's where we going. You go, and then you go.
I think she's lying about the herpes.
Periods. Like, why would periods come out? Now, this is, you really, really, you're sick. Who gives a fuck what I brought up, bitch? Do you hear this? I'm talking to my girl right now. Do you see when I'm screaming at you what the fuck I'm screaming at? What the fuck is she talking about? Do you understand? That's the same shit my girl says. Like, you didn't hear Kathleen. She goes, you brought up herpes. What, bitch? Like, you don't have the skills to argue with me. You know why women don't have the skills to argue? Because you've never had to argue a point to get
logically,
your point across.
Logically and
all you had to
concisely.
Do was argue up until the point where a nigga was scared he wasn't going to get no pussy.
You know what's
Whatever
funny?
Whatever point that is.
Patrice, you know what's funny? that Vaughn is laughing at this.
Because Vaughn sees, you know why Vaughn, my girl's laughing? Sit at the fucking mic, Vaughn. Sit at the mic. Do you know why my girl's laughing? Do you know why she's fucking laughing at you? Because I scream at her like this every day, cause she thinks I'm a bad guy when I do it. And it's really because she's sick. Kathleen, you are a girl. Don't get frustrated. You're a girl. You think you're not, but you are a girl. And you said 50 dumb things in 5 minutes, and I'm just trying to get you in a, cause she's the same way. My girl's the same way. She gets defiant. There's some ego in there, and that women have now, that they get this defiant thing where they think that they, listen, man, you're not better than us, ladies. Just understand this. I'm going to say this right now. We're better than you. You're better than what?
We're both better than Smitty.
You're both. This is,
we're not talking about
Smitty. Turn
Smitty,
up my mic back on.
Yeah.
Ready, everybody? Drum roll, please. This is what she just said. What did you just say just now?
You said
no.
You're
hear
not
you,
better than
do you hear, do you
we
hear
are
what,
both.
No,
we are
say, turn the mic off. I'm gonna teach you. It's your mic's off. No one hears you. I'm gonna teach you. This is what I'm doing. I'm a fucking teach you because this is what you need. What did you just say when I said men are better than you?
We're both better than Smitty.
You're both better than Smitty. Ready
speaking
now?
Speaking of Yvonne and
whoa. Why are you better than Smitty?
He's an idiot. I'm sorry.
That's not a reason, Kathleen.
She's not going to get it, though. If it was me, if the argument was between us, she might be able to see it more clearly. But it's easier
you
to see it when you're not
you
in it.
You see it because you see it because you're standing on the outside.
I always see it when I'm standing on the outside. I love to watch it.
And that's
funny.
And that's really the point. The point is that when you're involved in the argument, your emotions block the logic, and you're not seeing whatever.
Okay, I will admit this. That guy, Smitty.
Holy fuck. Turn the mic off. Turn the mic off. Do you see? And she's still talking.
It doesn't matter about
you.
The point is, Smitty is not the point. That means...
Did you see the bitches? No one hears her.
That's not the point.
And she's talking.
Cat,
go ahead, Kathleen. Did you hear it? No one heard her out there. But I'm going to tell the world what she just said. I said, no one hears you. She said, I don't care. Do you see the sickness? Do you see the fucking sickness? You know who says that? I don't care when they're sick. Smokers. When you go, hey, man, you're going to get cancer. Hey, man, I don't care. Hey, dude, don't eat that pie. When people say to me, don't eat that pie. I got diabetes. You got to die from something. So when she has a fucking illness, right, and I go, no one can hear you right now because you turned your fucking mic off. She goes, I don't care. She is being defiant. Something happened within the month time. You know what happened? Somebody got to her because this is not Kathleen. This is what happens to bitches. They want guidance. Ladies, stop getting guidance from your dumb girlfriends. They don't fucking know shit. What do you know? You can't know shit. Do you understand what I'm saying? You don't know shit because you've never needed to. All you had to do is walk around and have guys want to fuck you. That's it. What else did you do to learn how to fucking argue with me and make sense? She makes no sense. Here's what women do. They have a movie in their head. It's starring them. It's guest starring them. Directed by them. You know the only thing that they don't do in their movie? Editing. There's no editing in the fucking movie. Oh, no. They play the villain because the villain will be me or the villain will be you. But they play you. This bitch over here will tell me what the fuck
wrote
I
your,
said.
Wrote
she
lines.
Goes, she'll get up, right? Because her fucking, she'll just be in her own world. She'll get up and go to the bathroom or something. I'm talking about my girl. And then something will happen. I'll look down at her feet or something. And she'll go, what? Oh, I know what you're going to get ready to say. You're going to get ready to say I need to lotion my back of my ankle. I said, no, bitch, maybe my eyes just went there, you insecure motherfucker. But at the same time, see that? That's a good place to be. I don't want her to get up and not give a fuck that I think her ankles are ashy or her feet don't look good. I want her to feel like she wants to appreciate the fact that I think she looks good and want her to look fucking good. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now, I went off on a tangent just now, but I fucking absolutely knew I did, and it made sense to the situation. Your tangent? No. I'm going to teach you that. I'm going to fucking teach you that. Look at you being mad and defiant. Look at you. It's the sickness coming up. It's the sickness. You're sick, Kathleen. I'm going to fix you.
Don't
You're
going to
be
me.
Great. You're going to be fantastic. Because this bitch, my girl, I'm telling you, you look at her, right? Here's what you're doing. You'll look at her and go, how do you deal with that? This is, every once in a while, we have to go through this shit. Me and my girlfriend have to go through me, like, going, what the fuck are you talking about? The other day, I had to threaten, listen, I had to put our relationship up. I had to crap out. I had to go, look, you're getting so sick right now, right this minute, that we might need to not break up, but you might need to explore Mr. Another guy who's going to, like, go, you're gorgeous every 5 minutes, or you're, oh, every five. I said, find that guy, and as soon as you get
until
ill.
You call him a pussy.
Exactly. As soon as he lets you get sick, and you don't respect him no more, and that's
pussy.
What the fuck is going to happen. If I don't stay like this, if I let you, right, do what you was getting ready to do on this radio show just now, like where you was going to be out of control. How the fuck can you, how would I ever get you in control? How would I ever go, hold on a second, Kathleen. I gotta shock you. This is shock therapy, bitch. Now I have to turn your fucking mic off. You understand? Fuck. I can't, but the bitches just make me sick. And you make everybody sick.
Michelle.
Everybody. All right. Hold on. Let me talk to John. John's in my sensibility right now. John.
Yeah.
Go ahead, man. Go. Just talk to me.
How you doing, Patrice?
What's up? I'm just fucking upset. Go ahead.
This right here, this is exactly why men run off in prostitutes. You hear what she said when you first started talking about the threesome? She goes, well, what do you want me to do? It's like every time you ask a woman, you know, you got some fantasy or something like that, it's like they're so scared that you're going to look at them wrong tomorrow. It's like, no, I can't share how dirty I am. Well, what do you want? And it's just so fucking aggravating. It's like, you know, I share my shit with you. Why can't you do the same thing?
Exactly.
You know,
now, let me ask you a question.
That's awful.
Let me ask you a question, though. Now, you got a wife, right?
Yeah.
Now, do you fuck your wife like you love her, or you fuck her like you hate her?
I fuck her like I love her now. Before, it was like I hated her.
Nigga, keep fucking her like you hate her. That's why she was into you. That's why you suck, because you got that frustration on your breath, because you're not still. Sometimes you slip up. Sometimes I look at my girl with like this. Exactly. My eyes blink. My eyes blink slow. I don't want to do no
baby
work.
Sweetums.
I want to just pumpkin, cuddle up with her, you know. But you got to fight
back.
Your way through that, John. Because I hear it on your voice. It's like, you know what the frustration is? You're too, you love her. You love your woman too much to treat her like a whore, which means you're being hypocritical. You understand what I'm saying? You need to rise above that shit, because that's the shit that used to happen to us in high school. What would happen to us in high school would be, okay, you try to, there'll be a school whore, okay? And she'll fuck everybody. And then you would never make her, no one would make that girl the girlfriend. They would always make, you know, Miss Sally, whatever, who was known to be, not the prude, would be the girlfriend. But you have to slay your fucking wife. The fact that she's a fucking a whore does not mean that she's not a good person. You know what I mean? My girl is a good girl. Wash dishes. You know, she even made me this horrible breakfast today. This bitch can't cook.
I tried.
This bitch, you should have seen the bacon the bitch made. I thought I was eating a shoe tongue, nigga.
Delicious.
And then she goes, I forgot the syrup for them. she made organic bread French toast and forgot the syrup. I almost smacked
it
in the face with this shit. I'm sorry. Go ahead, John. I'm sorry. Go ahead, man.
You remember? Like one of your last shows, you're talking about the whole competition thing. You know, if you do something good, then you just walk away from it. You know, and she gets jealous because she did not get to compete with you or feel like, you know,
right,
she's better than you.
But here's, let me.
It works. If anybody out there doubts it, it does work.
Absolutely.
I mean, when it came to oral sex, she felt like the competition was on, and it got so much better when I just walked away.
When you didn't expect her to give. When you didn't expect her to be selfless, you was just like, but that's the key to giving, man. Never give with the idea that you're going to get something back. You eat her pussy because you a pussy eater. You eat her pussy. You know what you eat her pussy like? You eat her pussy like if it was removed from her body. You would say, thank you so much, sweetie. I got your pussy in my hand, and I don't need to talk to you no more. That's how you eat pussy. You eat it like you'll eat anybody's pussy like that. Because that's what their thing is. Oh, I'm special. You know what I mean? So when you do some things that make them don't feel special, then they're like, holy shit, they feel special. You like that, then they start to understand that there's a fight. There's a fight for your tongue. You know what I mean? That your tongue is somewhere out there.
Hey, I know it sounds weird as shit, but it's the truth.
Absolutely. Thanks, John, for calling, man. Appreciate it.
Marry the whores, too. Stop marrying the prudes. We have to encourage the filth.
Do you want to share?
Yeah. What do you want to share?
Share with your girl, your woman.
All right. My lady was a female stripper when I met her. And
bad motherfucker too. She's so bad I gotta look away because it's my nigga's wife. That's why at least. That's why. Wait a minute. That's why I have to hang out with my girl, because I think my girl is there the same level of fineness, so it doesn't make me feel guilty if I look at Dante's girl as long as she has something to look at too that he might want to fuck.
I am bad as a motherfucker. You gotta definitely curb your, whatever.
But your wife was a
smoker.
And talking about threesomes, you got son.
Yeah. Alright. Here's the cardinal rule for not, fucking up a threesome. No.
You gotta finish blaming your wife as a stripper.
And
the context is, everybody out there, the context is that you see a girl, you know, just talking to the girls or talking to the guys who still have these utopian kind of ideas, is that, oh man, dude, you fucking married a stripper? Let me tell you something, man. Women's bodies are just not under your control. Your girl's body, you have to condition your mind to understand that your woman is, you have to look at your woman like a complete whore physically that will just fuck anything that moves, so that you have to, you know what you have to do? I picture my girl fucking like two strangers in the street. And I mean, I really imagine that she's doing it. I imagine scenarios on how she's going to fuck somebody. I imagine scenarios on how she could. She works in, you know, she works somewhere where she meets a lot of people. And I picture, I imagine her walking to the bathroom and sucking some guy's dick. I imagine it. And then it your stomach knots up, and then you go, all right, you start to figure out a way to get through it so that you can function. Because even if she sucks a dick of some motherfucker, because my dick is not, look, man, I wish I had a bigger dick. She gives me the whole, she gives me the
perfect.
Whole. It's fine.
It's perfect.
But I know that I missed the spot.
Sure.
I get the spot with the fingers, but I know I missed the spot with the dick.
A quarter inch.
Well, you make up for it with your fist.
Turn on mic on. Hold on.
An average size penis or a small one?
Ask your question again. You wasn't on. Ask it again.
Does Patrice have an average size penis or a small one?
What is an average size?
Like that. Like.
Who you been fucking? Small as hell.
She
like
hell. She gave us a 3-inch
mandingo.
She gave a 3-inch dick, which means I would fuck the shit out of Kathleen. wait.
Ouch.
Well, let's see how big, like six inches.
That
like,
closed up mental pussy.
It, but I think it's bigger than 6 inches.
Well,
damn, they're bigger than 3.
Like wide or thin?
6 inches wide?
No, no. Is it a wide dick?
No, it's not wide. It's like. It's not skinny, but it's not like a fist wide.
Okay, now it's testicles.
It's like,
are they tight up or do they hang?
Sometimes they're tight and sometimes they hang.
Oh, okay. Okay. But he's at, well, you can't.
Look at it. Exactly.
No,
exactly.
I can say.
Look, every guy in this place is like, how can you turn that conversation into like, huh? Like, after she goes, is it this wide or is it this wide? And then Kathleen will go, okay. Like, you know, like a guy would ask, we would know why we were asking that. Like, if I said, yo, is a pussy small?
All women talk like that. All women.
Turn her off for a second. If she, it's like, if a guy goes,
that pussy's wet.
Yo, let's
sloppy.
We gonna have a conversation about pussy, right? This is it. Yo, yo.
Yeah.
What's that? Yo, was it small? Was a pussy small?
Sloppy. It was
it was sloppy.
Sloppy. Like it looked like somebody sneezed on it.
So it was just
creepy, just creamy, just creamy.
Just wait, it was like that. It was like that on its own?
Right, on its own. Just talking.
You didn't spit on him?
Nothing. I did spit on it, but
it was,
snotty right out the gate.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Ugh. Oh, filthy. I told her too. That's a look at your sloppy, nasty.
Wait a minute. How big was the lips?
She was like, she had a little curtains, a little roast beef hanging. I like a little roast beef.
Nigga, I like roast beef too, nigga, but I like some bitches, they had that little line pussy. I hate a line where you don't see the clit. You know what I'm saying?
I like the little hanging. I like a little hanging.
But like, Bobby don't like a
he don't like
sneezy, snotty pussy. I like a filthy pussy.
All right, awful. Dripping on the balls, everything.
Wait a minute, though. But was it tight on the inside, or was like it was? Just,
I don't really like a tight pussy.
You like it?
I like a pussy with a little mileage on it.
Well, in my dick, I'm not packing that much, so I do like it to. Well, my girl's pussy just out. I think it's outgrown my dick.
Like a drunk dude's mouth.
I did get a fist in there. Yeah.
You get a fist
But listen, I worked hard to get a fist in there. I started at 2. I don't know how it did it. If there are any doctors out there, please let me know. Am I doing something bad to my girl's pussy? Because I can get a fist in, not just like punch it in its end, but it has conditioned itself to be able to have it in there, and it's just oh my god! And she loves it too, which makes me know my dick just doesn't have a chance. Because my dick does. You know what my dick makes her? My dick. We make love when my dick is in. Like that's the break. That's the break from my fingers is when my dick is in. She goes, I love you. That's when she can focus. She focused when my dick is in. She's like, oh, I gotta pay a bill. When my fist is in, she's like, and then I put my dick in, like when she's coming, and I take my fist out, stick my dick in, and she goes, hand me that water, please. Listen, put my contact. Let me take my contact out. My dick ain't shit. I really want a bigger dick. I do.
Like, but it stay hard for a long, long time.
I'm good in the sack. But I think if God gave me one of those fucking ridiculous dicks, I just wouldn't need to have a personality, you know, because I have the kind of dick that you can pull pants out and show. Like, you could bitches
whip
are fucking,
out.
You can go, hey, baby, you couldn't handle, because women are very.
Oh, whip it out.
They're statistical.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Man. That's how little Kev gets his pussy. His dick is, it's a man child. He's 7 inches tall.
And
And the nigga's dick is like the shade, the thing that the shades roll around when you pull the shade down, that stick. It's like that when the shade is completely up, nigga. Like, it's the kind of dick that stops a room where everybody's like, let me tell you, let me say something to everybody here. And Kevin's dick can just come. His dick is like cymbals. Like, everybody's like, like if everybody's talking, he pulls his dick out. My dick is the triangle. The nigga.
No, it's not.
You know what? She loves me, so it's like.
See, that's the.
No,
that's,
but you can't be
thing
into big, big, huge dicks all the time. That would be like getting a fist every single night.
Did you hear that? Did you just hear how she destroyed my self-esteem?
No, it's not. Of course.
I was gonna ask that though. I know a couple of chicks that say they've dealt with dudes with huge monsters, and could not, and just was like broke
right
up with them.
What
just
kind of monster?
Like,
what kind of monster you got? My monster. In terms of if my dick was a monster, it would be. It would be. My dick is, in terms of the monster, Eve, I would say my dick is the mummy. Not
the
even,
mummy?
Maybe the mummy.
The mummy?
Just slow. It'll get there. a motherfucker, once he gets you, He like the mummy, once the nigga grabs you, he has to kind of use other shit too.
Right.
That's why I'm the mummy. I would say I would have to, like, I go, and I grab the bitch, and I got her, but I got to do a lot of other shit.
I would say, I'm like Freddy Krueger. Like,
why you not packing that much either?
Well, I threw
packing.
Nine.
You packing a nine?
Nine.
1 inch is big.
You packing a fucking nine?
It's like a nine.
Are you bullshitting?
No.
Tell the truth, dude.
Like a nine.
That's brutal.
Nah.
That's a giant dick, son. What? That's a giant dick.
It's not a giant. Look, let me, like.
What you packing, Eric?
Nine.
You have no idea what you're packing? Jesus.
That
Eric
means three.
Eric's packing the top of the microphone.
Show
like
me a nine. Show me a nine. That's not nine. That's like a 14.
No.
Oh, my God.
That's 14.
No, that's not. Okay. That's 14. How big do you think the napkin hold, the thing that the napkin's wrapped around is?
About a foot.
That's about a foot. 12, 13.
So take 3 inches off of that. That's your dick?
Oh, well, I like that.
That's I don't want to give you a nine.
Wait, right here?
That make me not be your friend, Dante.
Can we do a train?
No, you can't fuck Dante.
No,
no, you can't do. You can't fuck Dante. That's my friend.
Can't.
I was just playing.
Cause then you ain't playing, ho. Fuck you think I'm? Bitch is the dirtiest ever. Hold on, man. Let me take somebody.
Vaughn is 2 seconds from fucking my wife anyway. That's why they can't hang out.
I know, that's true.
Huh?
Patrice.
Oh, they're girls. I'm sorry. Oh.
Patrice.
Hold on. Let's get to a couple of bitches. I'm sorry. Tell my husband what I want and it works. Ex-husband bailed out of a threesome. Wow.
Pussy.
This is a good one. We're going to go. Wait, who was on longer? We're going to go with Michelle because she was on longer. But that's interesting. Michelle? Yeah. Michelle? Michelle? Pudding? Hey, bitch. Michelle?
Yes.
Hey, go ahead. I'm sorry. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm sorry to keep you waiting, man. I'm just
that's
trying
right.
to condition these hoes. You know, go ahead.
You're hilarious.
Thank you, Puddin'. Go ahead.
Well, I was involved in a threesome by my own choice with my ex-husband.
Nice.
Time out.
Okay.
Was it a train or was it a threesome?
No, it was me and some other chick.
Delicious. Okay, go ahead.
Nice.
And him.
Oh,
kind of.
Okay.
Oh,
kind of.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay. We've been married like 11 years or 12 years, something like that. And he said he kept, you know, always telling me that he wanted to have a threesome and, you know, he's always wanted one, blah, blah, blah. So we used to hang out at this coffee shop and I recruited this chick to come to bed with us.
Nice.
Just barely legal.
Because,
you know.
Oh, wait a minute.
Just barely legal.
Wait a minute. This might be a woman who actually deserves to be alive right now. Wait a minute. Wait a second. Now, how old are you?
I'm 33.
Wow.
Oh, so you're close to retirement. Now are you hot?
No, fuck no. I ain't no fucking cougar.
Are you hot-ish? Or are you hot?
No. I'm hot enough. I make my man happy.
You're sort of hot. All right, no offense. We're trying to get a sense of who the fuck you are.
Just need a picture.
Okay, so you're in Oklahoma, so like you got.
Oh no, I wasn't at the time. I was in California.
You were Cali. Did you have aspirations to be an actress and all that?
No, I was in Sacramento.
Okay, Sacramento white girl wants to do it. Okay, 33 years old. You're 33 now.
I was like 29 at the time.
You was 29, so that's definitely you was moving into the later years.
18-year-old blonde, nice, curvy girl home for him.
So a fat white girl.
No, not fat. She just had some junk in her trunk and like that.
He was a fat bitch. Come on, stop playing. Stop playing, Michelle. She was a little
dress size.
She was fat. She was a little chunky.
What, you want a dress size on her?
Yeah, get a dress size.
Yeah.
Like 8.
Hey, she was chunky.
8 is nah, 8 is right in the park.
Well, 8 is great for us. 8 is suicide for a white
dude. It's that fat bitch.
8 is bitch don't eat. The bitch eat air and go throw up. Oh my God, I breathe too much air. I'm dying.
So you got a
19-year-old chick. Okay, fair enough.
Oh, no, she was 18.
Okay, delicious.
She was 18 years old, and I told him, I said, I've got Christina. Her name was Christina. I said, I've agreed to bring her home.
Mm-hmm.
When you get home from work, we're going to do it.
Okay.
He said, okay.
Okay, okay. Go ahead.
So before he got there, I got her liquored up,
uh-huh.
and I went down on her.
Okay.
To get her primed.
Okay.
Nice.
And I'd never been with a girl before, mm-hmm. but let me tell you, she was crawling at the back of my couch.
Go ahead.
Yeah, pretty much.
Go
you
ahead.
Know, I know what I like.
I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you what the fuck happened. Now, what ultimately happened?
Okay, so he comes home, we get naked, we're in the bedroom, we've been drinking a little bit. And he
now
is
we
not.
We is us or we is you and the girl?
We is me and her.
Okay, we see what's going
on. Okay,
happen.
We get in the bedroom, we're all naked. You know, he plows his face between my legs, and she's kissing me because, she, you know, she's only 18 years old. She's never done this crap before.
I'm filling up right now.
And,
go ahead. I need me an 18-year-old.
Anyway, so
I was going to try to fuck Kathleen after the show, but she's too old. Bitch is 46.
You know
fuck it. Go ahead. Go with the 18-year-old.
She takes up a lot of your airtime, buddy.
Oh, she's fine. I'm teaching her. Don't worry. I picked
good.
It up, Michelle. I'm,
focus.
Yeah, go ahead, Michelle.
I'm trying
go ahead.
To hear this story.
Yeah, this
oh, that's cool. Anyway, anyway, he's doing his thing, and I didn't, you know, nobody was given any rules. This we're going to do this first, then we're going to do this.
Right. You just was into it.
Anyway, are you there?
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, okay. Anyway, he just gets up, and he says, nobody's paying attention to my dick, and he gets up, and he leaves.
Fair. Uh-huh. Well, that was a self-explanatory story. That's he was jealous as a motherfucker, but here's...
Jealous of you and the girl.
Here's threesome...
Yeah, pretty much.
Here's threesome rules, number one, and I'll tell you this while you're on the phone. Threesome rules, number one, is that you're not... He felt inadequate. He was
inadequate.
He felt...
He's a 10-second man.
And let's be honest here. Let's be honest, Michelle.
You like that little 18-year-old.
You was into that 18-year-old. This story... See, here's how you being slick. You're not making yourself culpable for the situation. You were into the bitch.
The party was on before
way
he
more
got
than you should have been. That motherfucker came in with his dick and you went, aw, the wah-wah music came in. Because she wanted to be... Now, me and my girl was in a couple of threesomes, and what I tend to understand is that you let two girls go at it. Because eventually, unless they're
a
complete
dick.
Dykes,
yeah.
they're going to grab on a dick.
Yeah.
And secondly, hey, Michelle, thanks for calling, sweetie. Appreciate it.
No problem.
Oh, keep listening.
Oh, wait, though.
Yeah,
I have to tell you.
Go ahead.
She went to the other room to go to bed, and he went there and tried to get it from her. Later on that night.
You motherfucking. I'm looking at Dante Nero in his fucking face right now. You're going to tell that story. Oh, my God. I'm glad you said that at the end. What?
She told him, fuck you. You had your chance.
Oh, my God. Wait, are you still with this guy?
You backed out, motherfucker.
You left him, didn't you? You left him, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you see?
We parted ways.
Fellas, do you see how important? Thank you. Thank you, Michelle. Do you see how important it is for you to like? Here's something that you don't want. Here's why. Okay, if somebody says to my girl, I know a guy or two that she you know, but I didn't know her, so well, you know, she do what the fuck she want to do before she know me, and I'm trying to put her in classes, you know, put her in schooler, but. She fucked a few guys, and if a guy came up to me trying to disrespect me, talking about, yeah, I fucked your girl, right? I wouldn't be like, you know, you fucked him. I would go, really? Now, let me ask you a question. Did you stick your tongue inside of an asshole, nigga? Did you do that? How about choke the shit out of her? Huh? How about that? How about, yeah, did you find that out, huh? Did you bite her tongue off or something? Whatever I did last
There's night. Only
I just bit her tongue. Turn, damn, Dante. Whatever. Yeah. Somebody's phone. So the thing is that you gotta understand something. Where was I? Because I lost that fucking stupid phone. Took me off.
You were saying how you don't care that I fucked other people that you know.
Right.
And what you would say to them.
And the other part about him fucking the girl, trying to fuck the girl after the threesome.
I lost my train of thought. Who the fuck is paying attention to me? I'm all over the place.
After the threesome, he went and tried to fuck the 18-year-old.
Yeah. Right, but that's I want you to tell that story. You're a fucking asshole.
Yeah, no, whatever.
You fucked it up, and you can fuck it up for all of us too. Let me tell you something.
Well, it's my research, it's field research.
It's field research.
I can pass it on.
No, you know it fucked up. Wait a minute, I have to finish something about my girl fucking other guys. Oh, here it is. It's the ego, fellas. You have to let go of your ego when it comes to this kind of situation. Do not, when your girl, if your girl wants to do a threesome, the main thing about a threesome, it's not you trying to fuck two girls. What it is you're fucking your girl, and there's another bitch that's doing shit.
Yeah.
it's almost like she, like if you're fucking and your dog jumps in the bed, you go, hey, get out off the bed. Like, it's a dog that you want to lick your balls. You know what I mean? It's like the threesome.
The third party is ambiguous. It's just a body. It's not a personality. It's not a.
Even if it's two bitches that you don't know, you pick one. That's the one that you're going to, like, be into. And then the other one, you always want to fuck the one that's not into it as much. But you want to, like, the other one who's just a complete trooper, you let her be the fringe bitch because she don't give a fuck. But the other bitch, and I'm talking about if you fucking you meet two girls at a bar and you take them home, is like, you want to fuck with the one that's kind of into it. Like, put it this way. If you met Kathleen and my girl at a bar, fuck Kathleen. Try to fuck her. And my girl will go, oh, okay, there's a ball open. there's an open ball. I'll just grab an open ball, nigga. I don't give a fuck. Wait a minute. Hold on. Hey, Christina, stay on the line, okay, pumpkin puss? Don't go nowhere. But I want Dante to tell his story real quick. All right, we gotta take a break, right? We're gonna take a quick break, but we're gonna come back with Christina. Do not go, and we're gonna get to we're gonna rifle through calls. I promise. After we come back, after Dante's story, after Dante's wife, the top no-no of threesomes, the no-no threesome shit, and then we're gonna get to every call that we can. We're gonna rifle through calls. I promise. All right. So Jerry and fucking Jay and G. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, we'll be back. Oh yeah, did we give Kathleen back her mic privileges? Oh yeah. Kathleen, she keep looking at my girl like, come on, let's gang up as
girl
women.
Power.
No, no, baby. Oh yeah, my girl knows a bitch ain't leading her nowhere but to the fucking bottom of the ocean. Oh, yeah.
She let loose in the bathroom, though.
Really?
A little talk.
Wait a second. Y'all was in the bathroom talking?
Mm-hmm.
You gave her a little talk?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of talk you gave her? You got some curls sticking up, too. Wait, put this shit down.
Where?
Back.
Oh.
It's kind of looking goofy. I can't pay it. I can't even ignore it. The shit's sticking up like alfalfa, bitch.
Is it down? Is it down now?
Here. What y'all talk about?
Well, you made me forget. Now I'm thinking about my curl.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Oh, don't pull that hard. I got black people here.
Sorry. Wait a minute, baby. So, wait a second. Y'all was talking in the bathroom. You was trying to ease her, like, you were trying to, like, tell her it's okay and stuff?
Yeah.
What'd you say to her?
Oh, sorry. She said, the first thing she said to me was, I would just smack him if that was my boyfriend.
Yeah,
I told her, yeah, that's exactly what I used to say. But
play that song again, Danny, why did you tell her that?
But I did tell her that it's just the truth is painful. But once you get past the anger of it,
what truth is painful, Pumpkin?
Those type of arguments that you two were having. Like, she couldn't see, like, the truth in it and where she was wrong because it was a lot of anger.
And what did you do to try to coax it through? What did you say?
I told her that once you get past the anger, you learn a lot about yourself. That I've learned a tremendous amount in the past 4 years that we've been together.
Don't look at my girl, Dante. Don't you dare look at her, you 9-inch dick nigga.
Don't
you ever look at my bitch like that. You drink that beer and you look straight ahead. You motherfuckers. All you motherfuckers. Look at that fat Patrice like, I think I can get his girl. You have no respect for me, nigga. So you you look out the window, nigga. Wait a minute. So
I ain't gonna front. You about the only thing I worry about, though. That's it.
And what he said, means is I'm the only nigga he worries about.
Enough.
Yeah, getting his woman, and we. That's why we keep each other close. Me and Dante. Wait a minute, Danny. Oh, man, I'd love... Just keep playing again. That was hot. Do it again. I don't give a fuck. Don't we rewind? Oh, my God. Wait a minute. Oh. Now, Kathleen, Now, you said you came in there, right? When you came in, you was a little bit miffed.
Right,
you,
right.
Like, how you deal with that? I'm fucking slapping, right? Now, when she said to you, when she said to you that, hey, once you get past the emotions of it and everything, right? What,
yeah.
Like, what did you then feel after she kind of, like, said, no, he's not bad? What did you kind of feel?
No, no. Most of what was said about you was positive.
Right,
like,
right.
I said, I don't go for that type. I go for more of the Bill Gates type. She said, right. Been go, there, done that.
Go for the safe.
And I said that, you know, I like the bad boy type, but I've been there, done that with the good guy type, and that Patrice is the perfect balance in between.
The balance
the
of
bad
two.
Guy that treats you like a princess.
Yeah. And then I said, well, yeah.
All right, stop the music. Shit.
Wait, but...
Fuck! My girl was getting my dick hard.
Wait.
Here comes Edward G. Robinson. Well, I got the Bill Gates type.
Wait, on the way out, see, guess what the last thing she said was, though?
What?
But that Smitty guy pissed me off.
You still mad at Smitty? Why was you fucking mad at Smitty?
Going back to Smitty?
Because he said she had AIDS.
In 10 seconds, why was you so fucking mad at Smitty? In a nutshell.
Because he was trying to be funny by presuming I had herpes.
That's what pissed her off.
That
he said
pissed me
she's
off.
She's probably got herpes.
She wouldn't have,
But why would you be so mad at that?
You don't even know that dude.
Like he.
I don't know him,
but why did that
and
hit
I
such
don't
a,
care.
Why did that hit such a nerve, dirty pussy? Come on, Bumpy. Why? Because she—that's why she wouldn't tell you. That's why she wouldn't tell you what a herpes outbreak looked like. Because she'd be like, well,
no,
how you know, crunch and munch, pussy?
Patrice, I have never so much as had a yeast infection.
Oh, shut
never.
Up!
You ain't getting fucked right. That's
you
why.
Had something going on.
Yeah,
somebody's tapping that
nothing.
Kidney. You gotta get a
totally
yeast infection.
Totally clean.
That means you just
totally clean.
You just shut up.
Sanitized.
I'm tired of you and your phoniness. I'm gonna get it out, Kathleen. Look at it, I'm gonna get out. I'm gonna fucking get the truth out of your fucking old used up ass. All right, cut her mic off. We'll turn her back on when we get ready. All right. That's right. You like it, huh? Take it. Take it. All you can do is sit there and be upset, baby, and you're gonna like it. Then one day you'll come out the bathroom and tell somebody I'm a good guy that I'm cursing out. One day you'll give advice that I'm not a bad guy.
And you got a nice face.
And I give you what you need, not what you want. You think you want what you want, but you got to get what you need. You know what I'm saying? Don't you want to eat a fucking box of donuts every day? But you can't. You can. You want to, but you can't. Right? Sometimes a guy has to introduce what you can't do to your life. Okay? And right now, you can't talk, bitch. Uh-huh. So, look at you. Yeah, take it. Keep looking at my girl going, how do you deal with it? And the fact is, she's fucking keeps looking at my girl because she's like, I want to fuck his girl. She's so sexy. How does she deal with that? That's the reason. See, I catch him. This is when I catch bitches. It's hard to catch you when you're LeBron James, when you're young, you run fast, you jump high. It's hard. It's hard to give you advice. My bitch was LeBron James in her time. But at some point, she's getting a little Karl Malone-ish, and she needs to fucking know. She needs to know.
Are you calling me old?
You know.
I'm 31. Fuck you.
She's an old bitch. 30 is old. You know, what motherfucker, what top player is 31 in the game? You know what I mean? Malone. She was LeBron. LeBron, when he turns 31, he's going to be a little less effective. But if he gets the right coaching and has the right sensibility, he'll change his game. Mm-hmm. And he'll be able to be happy and stay in the league a lot longer than, like, that bitch Michelle, she fucking did something that tried to keep him in the game. Yeah. And what he did, he still, he couldn't deal with it.
Buckled.
It was personal. It's like what Cotton Fitzsimmons did to the Iceman. Iceman was the baddest motherfucker in the league. Man. Cotton Fitzsimmons said, I'm just going to control this nigga. I'm going to control him. And it's just like, you know what? You're so defiant and so fucked up that you don't even know that you got a good thing. You know what I'm saying? Mm. So that's what happened. Michelle's man just fucking, he was such a personal, had an ego and was all fucked up.
And he asked for the threesome.
But you know what it was?
Crazy.
It's the ego, fellas.
Yeah.
You have to get rid of that fucking ego that a bitch won't do what she wants to do. He got an ego because she fucking was in control. But women are in control of the fuck game anyway. But what we try to do is we try to convince them to relinquish a little bit of that control to us. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got to get them to slightly, like, say, ooh, I want to give him pussy. I want to bring another bitch in. It's a mind thing. That we don't control their bodies, man. Women's whole essence, like, men's dicks are different from their mind and different from their heart.
Separate entities.
We have three different things going on. Our mind, our heart, and our dick. Women have one thing going.
It's all connected.
It's all connected. So, you know, once a bitch can just decide, okay, I like him and I want to do for him, the body's yours. That's why Kathleen, hold on, Dodger. I'm just going to explain why Kathleen looks at me and my girl and goes, I don't get it. Because she doesn't have any direction. She doesn't have an option on how to think differently. Kathleen is very in the box, very theoretical. But that's the reason I like her as a girl, because women are not that theoretical. It's that you don't meet a lot of women who are analytical. That's why women are dumb. That's why you never see any women great women chess players. Name a woman chess player in the world. That's why you never see great women generals. That's why, have you ever heard a nigga go, hey man, let's read a book, let's talk about Socrates, Aristotle, Nietzsche, Confucius, and Susan. Ain't no philosopher, bitches. When the fuck you ever see a bitch on a fortune cookie? Or a bitch, you know what I mean? Because y'all
There's
think...
One bad bitch.
A philosopher?
Yeah.
What's her name?
Ayn Rand.
Exactly.
Ayn Rand.
Who the fuck knows that but you, Dante?
She's a bad bitch, though.
What's her name?
Ayn Rand.
Ayn Rand.
Yeah.
Lesbian?
Probably.
So. I never heard of her. But she's good. Dante read a lot about this shit. But let's be honest. You got to name 85. You can name 85 philosopher guys.
Oh, absolutely.
And then you got to pull out some bitch that nobody... I'm talking about... And when I say... You first of all, nigga, when I say Aristotle, you can't say Ayn Rand. I'm saying the bitch version of Aristotle.
I gotta say, she smoked.
That's like the bitch version of Jerry Smith, the philosopher in fucking Utah, nigga. That's what you. But that's the point. You gotta dig up some old obscure shit.
Yeah, all right. Women have only been formally educated for the last 100 years.
Go ahead, give her a mic. Go ahead. All right, she might have something to say. Go ahead. Go ahead, sweetie. Look at the frustration. Look at it. I like it. That's what it's like. Turn the mic off. That's what it's supposed to be like. That's a relationship. You should be. Now she has a. Look at Kathleen now.
The same frustration.
When the mic is on, she's a little nervous to talk and she's getting a little like back and forth because she's not as comfortable opening her big fucking mouth. Now she better have something to say or she's getting disciplined. All right, turn it back on.
She gonna want to fuck you by the end of the day.
Your mic's all
never
precious.
Never mind.
Look how mad she is. Yeah, it's coming up. The sickness is coming up. She gonna pull a titty out soon. I guarantee your pussy's getting wet. Yeah, there it is, Kathleen. Oh, look at the fuss. Look at that. That's what my girl used to do. When I used to go, blah, 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 and she'll go, she want to talk, and then finally I go, okay, talk. But she'd be so mad that how dare you let me talk, that she can't even get her mind right. Yeah, what? What do you want? Say what you want to say. You have nothing.
I have nothing there.
You did.
Patrice, nothing.
Women have something 100 years. Yeah, I was listening. Yeah. Well, go ahead, baby. Go ahead.
Never mind. Ayn Rand wrote The Fountainhead. Read it. That's all.
That's it?
Objectivism.
Hmm. Interesting. All right. Cut her off. All right. Look at her. She's going to start crying soon. She's looking around. I like it. But it's good, sweetie. And don't you ever worry about not being. As long as Dr. Black Phillip is on, as long as the Black Phillip show's on, you're on. Trust me. But I just have to get you right. Hey, my girl was sick. Coming in sick.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're sick. That's all. I'm just trying to give you some medicine. Medicine doesn't taste good. You ever taste delicious medicine? No. I'm just trying to heal you. You're a sick bitch, yeah. Want to say something? Turn the mic on. Look how my girl, her mic has never had to be turned off. She can just talk anytime she wants. It's on. Is it on right now? Your mic on, sweetie?
It's on.
Oh,
yeah.
When she came on, when she was talking, everybody's dick got hard. You see anybody here trying to fuck my girl? I started to get up and smash a nigga in his head. She was telling a bathroom story, but she was just telling it, you know, yapping. Sometimes I still got to edit it. Today she was talking about, we rolled through the Holland Tunnel, and she saw that the Holland Tunnel says, no pennies, please. And she went on some tangent about, how can, see, pennies are currency, too. Why can't we have pennies? Blah, blah, blah. But you know what she did that she never did before? She went, her And our editor goes,
what the fuck am I talking about?
I'm talking about pennies, nigga? What the fuck is wrong with me? Somebody should kick me in my pussy right now for talking about pennies. And I go, good girl. And we shared a moment.
Yep.
My bitch actually said to herself, am I talking about pennies, nigga?
First time.
Fuck.
100% true.
All right. I'm going to get to a couple of calls. I'm going to go to this chick first, and I apologize to Jerry. We're going to get to Jerry, too, man. Matter of fact, we're going to get to Jerry right this second. Hold up. My girlfriend. Oh, man, this nigga been on an hour. Go ahead, man. Jerry?
Hello?
Yeah, man. Sorry to keep you waiting so long. Go ahead, man.
Hey, it's our play, man, but it's Gary. It's with the...
Oh, it's with a no, it's a G. Oh, okay, go ahead, Gary.
Yeah,
it says Jerry. Go ahead.
Take the R out. It sounds really gay.
All right, it looks whatever. Go ahead, man. What do you think?
All right, man. I got this. I got a little problem. I was hoping I could get some advice from the Patrice O'Neill there.
Go ahead.
I got me and my girl. We had a little situation there, and a little threesome may have had something to do with it. I don't
ooh,
know.
Threesome frankly, shit today. Go ahead, man.
Huh?
Go ahead. Go ahead. I'm sorry. It's just a lot of threesome talk today. Go ahead.
Yeah, there is a lot of threesome talk. I come home and. It ain't looking too good, bro. My spray painted, all the shit. I got motherfucker keyed in the back of the other one. My computer's in the sheetrock.
Wait. Food. We lost you. Wait a second. Hold up. Slow down, man. Slow down. You're not going to get cut off. All right. What the fuck happened? What happened? You did a threesome, and then what happened?
Well, nah, man, you know what? I tell you the truth, I don't know if that has anything to do with it. I mean,
do what? No, wait. Gary, we don't know what the fuck is going on. Like, what happened? I swear it sounds good. Sheetrock and computers, but you didn't tell the story. Go ahead.
I work offshore, partner, all right?
Okay.
Now,
like an oil rig thing.
Yeah, the oil rig thing, right?
Okay, all right.
Now, I come home one particular time, and my girl, she wants to go out, have a good time, right? We go out, and we come into her friend there, Tiffany.
Okay.
Who happens to be a friend of her, all that shit doesn't matter. Anyways, we end up going back. They got fucked up, and she started going down on the girl, I guess maybe to show off to me, you know, that she can spark out some lesbian love there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm kicking back, enjoying the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then we all get into it, right? Well, my girl, I guess, can't handle her liquor as much as the other one when she passes out, you know? Mm-hmm. So what am I supposed to do? I hear what you're saying all together, man. You're never going to have a threesome, you know. You're never going to be fucking another girl and then just switch off to your girl and shit, like, you know, on the point. You're with your girl, and
right.
The other girl is kind of like just like a fixture, like crown molding.
Right, okay, so your girlfriend passes out.
My girlfriend passes out. Anyways, I kind of put me and the other girl in an odd situation. But
oh, boy. You fucked the other girl, didn't you?
Classic. Yeah,
Gary,
yeah,
you
yeah.
You fucked the other bit, and that's what this asshole Dante had. Listen, man. Okay, wait a minute. I'm sorry. We're gonna get into you,
right,
but you know where you fucked up, right?
Yeah. Well, you see, I never fucked her after the fact. And
you
did that one particular incident.
You might as well had you. Do you? I mean, do you understand? Let's make sure you understand how you fucked up. Do you have any sense of how you fucked up then?
Well, I understand. Maybe I should have waited for my girl to get naked to completely understand.
You goofy nigga. Your girl passed out in her street clothes and you fucked this other bitch. You wasn't even in fuck mode yet, you greedy fucker.
Well, I mean, they were both drunk. They were talking. What am I supposed to do?
Okay, all right. Ready? I'm gonna tell you. Thanks. Hey, listen. Thanks for calling, Gary. I'm gonna tell you. No, number one. And that I learned.
One.
This is why my girl, I'm very frustrated because we want to have threesomes, but I have the skills to get another bitch to want to fuck. Because my girl really is the bait. You know what I mean? She's the bait. It's like if a bitch is thinking about fucking another bitch, she'll fuck my girl. You know what I'm saying? So basically, she's the bait. But what my girl doesn't mind, whatever I do with another bitch, as long as she's coherent
and not passed
and
out
I'm not too,
with her clothes on.
And I don't, it's not a developing relationship. That's why she wants the bitch to leave right away. Like, because it's still, she's still your girl.
Beat it.
But that's what I'm learning. Like, it frustrates me because she has no skills to get a bitch. Like, she just goes, like, she's learning the frustrations of a woman. Here's the, like, if you're trying to do threesomes out there, if that's your thing, and they, like, if you, and you know the like, the unwritten rule is that your girl brings the other bitch, right?
Yeah.
Now, what happens is,
She also initiates the action.
She initiates the action. I'm going to let you roll. Right after this, I'm going to let you roll because Dante is more of a pro at the threesome thing. But basically, she comes in, she kicks it to the bitch. But what happens is, here's the thing about women, if they're not lesbians. Here's the thing about bisexual women who really want to fuck another girl, but she still likes dick sort of thing. Like, she's 60-40 in favor of dick, but she'll put a girl in there. Is the frustration of pulling a bitch. That's what another woman gets fucked up on. My girl gets frustrated because now she gets to see what assholes women are. Like, cause she's down. She's like, hey, other girl, let's just do it. Let's fuck my man. And the other girl's like, I don't know. So she don't have skills. She doesn't have skills.
Or patience
to fucking coordinate frustration like men do, which is why innately we hate you motherfuckers, because you're never worth the trouble that we go through to fuck you. But as we're trying to fuck you, we hate your guts for what you're putting us through, because it's easy for you to just fuck us. Do you understand why we don't like you? Do you get it?
I get it.
Now she kind of understands. My girl is sitting in the cut. She's watching Kathleen. I'm not directing her mind. She's just watching Kathleen, and she goes, this bitch is nuts, because she sees it. Because I had to introduce the option of fucking nuts. Do you understand what I'm saying? And I don't mean balls. Because, and God bless, the fact is, another thing, I've conditioned my mind to be able to, like, if she needs to fuck another dude except for Dante, I'll do a train on my girl, because if she needs it. But thank goodness we both hate balls. We went to a swing joint, and just balls. They fuck. Like, I'm sitting there being like very cordial to the other motherfucker's bitch. I'm very gentle. I'm getting the other guy's bitch into me on this level. This nigga's jacking his dick over my girl's head. This nigga's like, I'm like, can you
have some
fucking
tact?
Stop clawing my bitch, please? She's here, nigga. This is not Dunkin' Donuts. We're in a swing club. Slow up.
You have some etiquette.
Find out what she likes. This nigga's trying to knuckle the bitch right away. Can you? And my girl's such a trooper. She's like looking at me like, honey, help. So I gotta be super rescue nigga at a swing club, like, hey, dude, hey, all right, listen, can you not knuckle my girl's asshole, dickhead? I'm sitting there like I'm massaging his bitch. But that's the thing she gets frustrated with, is that girls are so goofy. But the fact is, guys, sweaty balls, my dick don't get hard. It makes me sick. But if she needs it, I will do it. And I hope she doesn't need it. But if she goes, sweetie, I just want to suck your dick and have another guy fuck me, I'm about to go, all right. Because I know I want to see some strange pussy, and she'll oblige. You know what I'm saying? So here is Master Threesome Guy right here. Hold up. Well, Dante, keep, because Dante's a genius with the threesome shit, but he did what stupid asshole did.
I was 20.
So what, nigga?
Like,
no, don't start off with an excuse.
My lady used to, she was into women. And she was basically into women, but she was into
Dante's
me.
Dante's wife is fucking super fine, too. Don't forget that.
And she used to bring home chicks every weekend. Like, two chicks every weekend.
And what did y'all used to do, too, Dante?
Well, I would cook breakfast.
What was the fucking
like,
steam
it would be, it would be like, it'd be like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. Nice. I would cook breakfast. She would take the girl, put her
And would
in
this
the,
be other stripper bitches?
Stripper bitches, other bitches, just
your wife would just have game,
yeah,
like
she
that. She
game.
Would just pull. Oh God, go ahead.
Yeah, so she would take the chick, put her in the bathtub and wash her.
Oh boy,
shave her and wash her and just sponge her down and then.
What?
And then
my girl's such a piece of shit. She's
I'm
like,
more
I
of a guy.
I ain't washing a bitch.
I'm a man when it comes.
Well,
to women.
I think she did that. I think she did that to make sure the pussy was right.
It sets the.
Well, can't. You tell your story. Regular, the clip got to be right from jump for me.
Well,
whack
yeah,
that
you,
shit.
You know.
All right, go ahead, go ahead.
So then, and then I would feed the chick. We feed her, and then we both, like, she would initiate. She would make out with the chick and then go down on her. And then she, then basically I would
then you would come in with a crutch, nigga, and smack her back of the head.
Then I would, well, you build up to that. You build up to the crutch. You don't crutch out the gate. And then I would fuck my lady, and then I would move over to the girl, like maybe she'd ride me, and the girl would sit
on my
great, face.
Right?
Yeah, it was great.
It was great. Fantastic.
Fantastic.
Well, what fucked that up, then, Reggie? Go ahead, nigga.
It was this chick, she was like a runway model. She was hot. Let's be honest.
This may get to your wife's ears. I don't want it to cause no trouble, right, but let's be honest.
All right,
was the chick hotter than your girl?
She wasn't hotter, but the pussy was the bomb.
Oh,
the pussy was
the bomb. The bomb, but it was sloppy, snotty.
Now, you're not saying...
It was...
You're not saying what I hope you're saying, is that chick beat your girl's pussy out.
Yeah.
Possibly. Hey, look, bitch. Hey.
It was, I would put a high heel through your throat.
Well, look, a 19-year-old pussy got to beat your old twat out. Let's be honest here.
So
Her bladder's younger.
Well, your fist been pounding my bladder.
She's making an excuse for why her bladder's old. Now, nigga, you're the reason you made my bladder old, motherfucker.
And this is the point. This is the point why. This is why this is the number one no-no, because of just her action to that. To her response to the fact that I was feeling this other chick more is what it's about. And I went and bagged the chick up afterwards. Like, I used to I had a little side thing going on with the chick after the threesome.
You fucking started going out with the bitch.
Yeah, she was my other girl.
So would you say, now you know, here's how much I want to be honest to people. That, you know, that that's really just fucked up a lot of future threesomes. But at the same time, it's medicine.
Yeah.
Fellas,
it's the number one no-no. If she's comfortable enough with bringing a chicken, understand that she's doing that with the prerequisite that this is not an emotional connection that you have with this chick.
But you happen to bring in better pussy girl.
Yeah.
Oh, you fucking fire. Ass. You got to understand.
Our trip to Brazil is out.
Yeah. Oh, we going to Brazil too, by the way. Don't tell anybody that shit. Don't say when. Don't tell anybody.
But it's
I'm sorry, I got emotional.
So that's why. But that's why I'm telling Dante, hey, why don't you and your girl come? Nah, can't. Yo, how can you go from every week getting ass, she's washing bitches, to like, yo, let's go to freaking Brazil?
I was literally like, she was like, Daddy, can I bring her home? I was like, again.
I am gonna fucking. Every time I hear that story, I swear I wanted you out of the fucking Pimp Association of America, motherfucker. All right,
it's field research, so that I can pass on the knowledge.
We're going to go to, should we go? We just go to people who've been waiting, dude. Randy, no, we got to go to Christina. I'm sorry, Randy, Christina. Christina?
Yes?
Sorry, baby, keep you holding so long. What's going on, Pumpkin?
I wanted to talk to you about what you guys were talking about earlier.
Turn your radio down, too, Precious.
Oh, sorry. Okay. I've been married for almost 3 years now.
Okay.
All right. And since we were engaged and we started having sex and everything, it's always been he tells me what he wants and I tell him exactly what I want, and it's been perfect. No problems. We've even swapped partners with my friend and his girlfriend at that time.
Uh-huh. What?
We have a really great relationship when it comes to sex and everything.
Because you do what?
They swap.
Because we tell each other exactly what we want.
Oh, so like you got what they say.
He likes, excuse me?
You got what they say, an open relationship.
Completely open relationship.
So you don't mind if he, okay, ready? Here's the drum roll. You don't mind if he goes get side pussy outside of the house?
If he lets me know about it, that's fine.
Basically, it boils down to this thing. You're still possessive. Even though you're very open, it's still about, he can't get, what if he just wants some strange and don't want your dumb face in the room? What if he brings a bitch home and says, here she is, this is the bitch I would be fucking tonight, but sweetie, stay in the kitchen, would you?
Well, he wouldn't do that now.
See the girl coming out? Go ahead.
Yeah, exactly. He doesn't want, I wouldn't want him doing that in front of our kids.
Don't try to do a Kathleen role. We know what you're trying to do. Keep it focused.
I wouldn't do that to him. I wouldn't.
Who gives a fuck? You're a different animal, Pumpkin.
The point is, it's the emotional connection.
That's like an alligator asking a slug, you know, how come you didn't bite the motherfucker? I did. It's like you're not the same
thing.
You know what I'm saying? So basically, I'm saying if he goes
with another girl and said, I'm gonna fuck her. Can you stay downstairs?
Yes, I want to fuck her without you.
Okay.
I don't believe it.
Do you want me to put him on the phone?
Put this motherfucker on the phone. We're gonna ask him. Put this nigga on the phone.
Hello.
Yo, how you doing? Listen, this is Patrice. We're on a radio show right now. You don't mind, do you? Was you listening?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're listening.
Listen. All right. Now let me ask you this. Be honest. You guys do the little swap thing? You're the swingers. You do threesomes and things like that, right?
Yeah, it's great.
It's fantastic. But let me ask you this. Be honest. Have you ever wanted some strange outside of the threesome? Be honest.
What was the question?
Have you ever wanted some strange pussy? Have you ever wanted to fuck one of your threesome girls without your wife present?
Yeah, I've thought about it.
That silence was it. Now, this is something we're going to talk about one of these days, is why guys need strange pussy. I don't understand why. But she said I would never do that to you. Now, put her back on the phone for me, would you?
All right, hold on. Yeah, I want you back.
Hello?
He said that he has wanted, as great of a girl as you are, he said he still wants strange pussy without you.
I know.
Okay. Now if he's still coming on taking care of the kids and taking care of life and doing the right thing, why is it that he can't get a side piece of pussy without you?
No, he can. I would just like to know.
What if he didn't want you to know?
I don't want him just coming home and saying, oh, I just fucked some girl and, hey, I'm home now.
What difference does it make?
If he was to call me and say, listen, I'm here and this is what's going on, I'd be like, fine. That way at least I know what's going on.
All right, but
want the information.
She wants the other girl to be put in check. She wants the other girl to hear.
She wants the information.
That I'm
calling. So you want to make sure.
Honesty.
Yeah.
Okay, so this girl might be up for the award for best bitch in the world.
No,
so you're saying, I think it's some bullshit. Like, my girl, both women are saying.
She wants the other girl to know that her man is calling to get permission.
Wait a minute. So you're not going to deal with this.
Exactly.
You're not going to deal with this. Sweetie, I'm fucking another chick. No, nothing. Oh, shit. Hey, there's a beer. Drink it up. We having a good time. I'm just getting some side pussy, okay?
If he felt that he needed to whisper, but as long as he let me know, then that's fine.
If he's like, sweetie, and you go, wait, and you go like this at the end of the conversation. I love you. And he goes, yeah.
I'll see you later.
No other reason.
Yeah, I gotta go. Is that okay?
Yeah.
She's lying her ass
She's
off.
Lying.
You're
She's
lying her ass off. Stop playing. But you know what? Exactly. I can't deny that you are fucking, you're better than 86% of the bitches out there. Trust me. You're doing the best you can. You really are.
We have a really open relationship. He was aware when we started dating that one of my guy friends, his name was Mark, he's a year younger than me, and he had never been with a girl, ever. And he asked me flat out, if by graduation I have not had sex, mm-hmm. and we're talking about high school, he's like, can I have sex with you?
Oh, you are
and
a
I said, fine.
Animal, bitch. And, God damn it.
And I was with my husband at the time, was my
She's
boyfriend,
like,
well,
I
and I
take
told
care
him
this
flat out, I promised
prom
this guy
night.
That I would have sex. And,
honey.
Wait, you promised this
before
nigga?
Before prom night, I got to take care of something before we need a
listen,
break.
If you see me getting out of a stretch Hummer 2, nigga, with cum on my cheek.
It's just something I had to clear that up before.
I was keeping a promise. So you fucked it.
No, he was fully aware of it. He was actually in the other room when I did.
And you sound like white girl hot, too. Like, you sound good looking. Like, I don't know how to say that, but does she sound a picture? What do you look like?
I'm 5'4", Hispanic and Italian, okay. Brown curly hair and hazel eyes.
Nice. She didn't say the weight, though. Uh-oh, drum roll.
How much you weigh?
I'm not going to tell you how much I weigh.
Oh, fat bitch, damn it! Damn it, you was there! Baby girl, I'm still
trooper.
You are a trooper. I'm going to let you go, but God bless you. You know what? Your husband has a real trooper, even though I have a feeling that you might be doing it just to go, I'm going to stay in the game. But you know what? How old are you? Will you tell your age?
5 and a half.
I'm 25.
25? She is developing a fadeaway jump shot. She feels she had two kids. She probably got a little lasagna, some stretch marks because you're like Hispanic, and you know how you motherfuckers look. After pregnant.
After 12,
so
it's finished.
The Italian part is keeping you together, but the Hispanic and
after
Italian
12,
part are fighting.
You're finished. so 12 and a half, she's over
the
hill.
She got tight titties and a hangy ass. It's kind of weird. Like, so, but you're a trooper, sweetie. Thanks for calling. See you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye, baby. Are we going to talk to this nigga? Because he's been on there. He's a psychopath.
Randy, what's up, man?
Randy.
Hey.
Hey, man.
Hey, you know you put her husband on the fucking spot, right? That poor pussy whip motherfucker.
Well,
she was standing in the background pointing at him, telling him, "Yo, you better say this."
But he said that, but he was honest. That's the thing you got to be, man. You got to understand
honest.
Hold on a second, though. But this is one of the things that men have to teach to people out there. We have to teach our women to understand that it is what it is. Yeah. Meaning, we have to teach them to, like, go, okay, guys want to fuck other women. We have to get them to focus on the fact that we want to and then move on from there and stop getting mad at the fact that we want to. If you drop a motherfucking baby in the ocean and fucking Jaws eats your kid, you mad and you fucked up and you want to get retribution against that shark, but
shark.
It is what it is. Sharks eat anything that's in his face. So what you're dealing, you got to understand the animal that we are, fellas. We have to introduce that to women. And the fact is, yes, I want to fuck other bitches. Let's deal with that in itself. You know what I'm saying? So okay,
amen. Outside of the threesome.
Say that again?
Outside of the threesome?
Truth. Yes, bitch, I want to fuck other pussy outside of the threesome. I don't want you there fucking up my groove every 5 seconds.
Out.
I might want to do something you don't like. But the fact is, if I don't do it, wanting to do it is different from doing it. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I hear that.
Anyway, go ahead, Randy.
No, man, I know you speak the gospel truth, Patrice, and, you know, that stuff that she was saying about being honest, well, what's the difference if he comes home and says, oh, honey, I just finished fucking a girl? He's being honest, right?
Thank you, Randy. That's why that particular call, she was bullshitting a little bit, because right now, okay, when we're talking about animals, okay, when you turn on the light, roaches gotta run. You understand what I'm saying? No matter what you think you're doing, when you turn a light on, there's something in a roach that makes it run when the lights come on. You understand? So there's something, ladies, no matter how cool you think you are with being a hoe and how cool you think you are, my girl is a trooper, I'm telling you. But she can't get past that one part, which is another bitch outside of you. You understand what I'm saying? They can't get past it. So that's why the girl in Connecticut was a little bit dishonest, because she couldn't get past that. As she wants to have some type of control over the issue. That's why Dante's all fucked up. And his wife she should be as secure as possible to know, okay. But at the same time, man, she got mad and she was bringing bitches home and Dante still got greedy. It's something in us that we want to fuck strange, man. But and ladies, you can't get mad at it. Let's try to figure it out. Let's get together. Maybe that's our sickness. Like, I'm walking my girl. I'm looking at my girl's ass like, shit. She got a nice ass. nice pussy, you know, opens up as soon as I decide I want to see it.
And it ain't too many better.
I'll look at a short, stubby Mexican maid that's walking past with a mop in her hand and go, it's just the animal we are. You know what I'm saying? And I don't, it's not like I fuck them, but I want to. And don't be mad. Just help me through. Don't go, I'm mad at that.
Make me better.
You know what I'm saying?
Make me a better man.
Well, anyway, thanks for the call, Randy. Appreciate it, man.
Okay, Patrice. All
hope right. See you again. Later. Thanks for listening, man. Jerry, what's up, man? Jerry? Sorry.
Hey.
Yeah,
hey,
man, go ahead.
Hey, I'm married and I have a girlfriend.
And they both know?
And they both, yeah, they're living in the same house.
Hold on.
We all live together in the same house.
Stop the precious nigga. This nigga's
a pimp card.
Pimp of the year. Maybe the month. I don't know if this gets you. You're up for pimp of the month. All right, let's go ahead, nigga. How did you pull this off? First of all, you live in Connecticut, right?
Yeah.
All right, the last caller, the girl that the half Mexican, half Italian with the dude, they was from Connecticut too. So that's telling you something. Hey, tri-state area, run up in Connecticut because they all fucked up over there. You might be able to get some pussy and some other shit going on in Connecticut, I might say. But go ahead, how'd you pull that off?
Basically, my wife and I just wanted to have a threesome, and then
it stayed.
She never left. My girlfriend never left.
And wait, and that's what I try to tell my girl. What do they get along?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nah. See? Now, listen, baby. Hold on. But listen, though. You always say you want a friend. Right? A lot of times I go, sweetie, why don't you go out and get a friend or something? What if we meet a bitch and you really get along and y'all are friends and we fuck? What's wrong with that? This guy has it figured the fuck out, man.
That's how it works.
I'm speechless. I don't know. I'm not there yet. Maybe I'll graduate to that class. I'm not in that class yet.
Wait a minute. Jerry, how'd you get this going? Okay, wait a minute. We might be hasty giving him a pimp. Was this your wife's idea, nigga?
No, it was my idea.
You fucking introduced, hey, why don't we keep this bitch around?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
All right, how hot is your wife?
She's hot. She's got long blonde hair.
They're as hot as each other, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, but what was her first reaction when you said, and what did you say, first of all, and then what was her reaction? To get this thing introduced to have a living girlfriend.
We had all been working together at the same office, basically.
Oh, so they were friends
first.
And
we had all been hanging out.
No.
And I said, you know, I'm kind of getting a vibe, and I think that we should have her join us one night.
So you and your girl had already been trooping already?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay, wow. Cool.
Yeah.
Delicious.
And one night she came over by herself, you know, without some of our other friends. And
now, let me ask you, is your girlfriend your wife's girlfriend? Like, are they, you know, do they get together when you're not around? Are they licking pussy and everything when you're not around as well?
Not usually, no.
But they will.
Oh, yeah.
I like this guy, Jerry. I like this guy. Mm. This guy's a trooper, man. This guy's living the life.
He's a polygamist.
He's a...
And then I... Then,
look
then
at this bitch.
You're
a hoe. What kind of... The bitch said he's a polygamist with a hand on a fucking... So what? He's a fucking animal.
No, I'm saying he's not a pimp. It's his religion.
Let me not disregard this. Hold on. Are you... And this depends on your mic time.
Uh-oh.
Is this your religion?
No,
turn the mic on.
No.
You're on punishment, bitch. It started. See how sick she got? She was
she still fucked up about.
She just had an outbreak of dumb bitch. She just had an outbreak.
It was my story. It was my story. She's doing good.
Wait a minute, but her doses have gone down tremendously.
You did good.
But Kathleen
good.
Is super sick. My girl's on punishment. You see, they go steak is sick. Maybe it's his religion. You know why she said that? I'm going to tell you why she said that. Because a trailer she saw of that movie, on HBO.
Big Love.
Shut the fuck up. See, you're on punishment now. All right. Damn, dude. Jerry, you're a fucking trooper. There's nothing I can say to you but kudos,
Jerry,
my friend.
Put an application in for Pimp of the Year.
Yes, sir. I wish I could
think deeper. And you know, Patrice, the other thing is all that stuff you were saying about going out and fucking other guys, Uh-huh. It's all, I do all that, too. They do all that, too.
You know what? This guy, you figured it out. You've learned how to... Now, what's the thing you... Now, here's... Okay, you can help me, Jerry. You can help me kind of bring this to light for the guys, okay? What have you done to condition your mind? First of all, what have you done to condition your mind to be able to deal with this? And two, when you you're, I forgot I was going to ask the second. One is condition his mind.
Mm-hmm.
But the second is... Oh, wait, what the fuck is this? Too? Well, anyway, how'd you condition your mind to be able to...
Not be jealous.
To not,
not
be
to
jealous, to not buckle, and to not deal with that shit? How did you condition yourself to be able to deal with your wife fucking other dudes? Oh, here it is. And you love your wife, right?
Oh, absolutely.
That's what I want to ask. How was you able, and this is key, how was you able to cut the physical and say, okay, my wife is an animal, and then also look at her like... This is my wife, and I love her, and I want to take care of her. How did you separate that? How did that become oil and water for you?
Well, basically, you know, I understand it's just sex, and we're all human beings, and we all need it.
Mm.
And me, I don't, you know, I mean, I love my wife, but if she wants to go fuck a guy, go fuck a guy. I'll be here when you, and if you want to go with him, go with him. I'm going to find some other bitch.
This nigga fucking absolutely... Kathleen, Bravo. Why aren't you clapping? Why aren't you clapping, bitch? Why? You're sick. My girl ain't clapping either. Hey, man, Jerry, you are... Listen, call in every time I'm on, dude, just to let me know that there's troopers. And listen, first of all, I'm having a little problem. Thanks for calling, dude. I'm having a little problem. Too many troopers are from Connecticut. Where the fuck are the animals at? I wish I could have got his girl on the phone. He might have just been lying and shit. Fuck, next time, remind me.
Jerry.
Remind me.
I got you.
That next time a guy we give a guy too much
qualified
pimp kudos,
yeah,
we have to fucking test it.
All
right. My girl's looking me right in the face. Ah, Jerry, you motherfucker. Call back, nigga. if your girl is there listening, call fucking back. I want to talk to that bitch and your girl. Fuck. Son of a bitch. All right. Let me see. How to keep a girl trained. My wife's only changed the sex personality.
Well,
like that. I'll take Eric. Eric in Boston, my hometown. Eric, what's up, man?
Yo, what's up, man? How you doing?
Good, man. Go ahead.
All right. Here, need some advice, man. I got this girl. She's, you know, freshman in college, real kind of innocent. Hasn't been, you know, corrupted by any guys yet.
How old are you?
I'm 20.
Okay, go ahead.
And, and she's, you know, she's not a girly girl, you know, she never wears, you know, heels or doesn't
right.
need,
she's one
you
of
know.
The, she's one of the guys kind of thing going on, but she's
exactly,
not, she's not
exactly.
a lesbian, go ahead, you know.
Exactly, nice girl, everything's great and everything. Then about a month ago, all of a sudden, she starts buying, you know, the heels and maybe the Prada perfume and the Coach handbag or whatever. And I'm like, all right. I didn't think anything of it. I'm like, all right, whatever, you know. She's making herself look even better for me. That's great. Then, you
wait
know,
a minute. Eric, dude, I swear to you, I am so sorry for keeping you holding. But don't go nowhere, okay? I'm going to keep you on hold. I want you to finish your story, but I got to go to fucking Jerry. He got the two bitches on the line. Hold on. Now, is this the right thing to press hold and then go to Jerry? I don't want to hang up on Eric.
No.
Okay, I'm going to Jerry. This motherfucker got her on the phone. Jerry!
Hey, Patrice.
You got both girls there.
Yeah, we live together in the same house.
You
in my bed right now.
Fucker, this
pimp,
nigga here.
Hooray!
Put him on the phone. Put your wife on the phone.
You want my wife first?
I want... Yes!
All right. Here's
holy
here.
Shit!
You're looking for... Look at Vaughn.
Holy God. How you doing? Hold on! Now, you are the wife of this special man.
Yes.
All right. First of all, now, when you first started swinging, was you married or was you girlfriend and boyfriend?
We're married.
You were married when you started swinging?
Yeah.
Okay. So, at some point, did the sex get boring or you motherfuckers is just animals from the get-go?
No, it just sounded like a really interesting idea.
Had that been something that was floating in your mind for your entire, like, your sex career that you go, man, I wouldn't mind doing a threesome?
No, I think he brought it up, and it just sounded fun.
He said.
And he just brought it up. Okay. This
How are you? How much are you into women?
Bye. I like women.
So you're 50-50 or 60-40?
I'm like 60-40.
You're 60-40 dick?
Yeah.
So you like dick... But you will, that's my girl kind of thing. She likes to fuck, But she kind of long. You only really like to fuck your boy, your man, really.
Oh, no, I'll do other guys.
Oh, cool. This bitch is, she might have you beat, sweetie. You might be fired from this motherfucker. You might have to be fired from this shit. Would y'all come down to the show one of these days?
I don't know if I can get him there.
Oh, like right now, like on a Saturday, just like tonight, or I think the show might be Thursdays, but could you think you'd come from Connecticut and come through so I could just look you in your eyes? Because I'm having trouble believing this. So he said, after you guys had the threesome and you fucked the girlfriend, right?
Yeah.
When you fucked the girlfriend, was it like with the intentions that she was going to get the fuck up and get out, or...
Well, not exactly.
She's like a nice...
It wasn't like, you know, we were... It was just like... It wasn't going to be like a one-night stand kind of thing, but it wasn't initially...
It was like a weekend?
The intention of it becoming, you know, a nine-year relationship.
You've been together for 9 years? Like,
yeah.
How does this work? Please tell me how this works.
It has its ups and downs. You just kind of...
Okay, when does the bitch... jealousy come in? That's what we want to know. Jealousy? What moments make you jealous?
Lots of little things.
Okay, let me ask you this:
you can talk yourself out of that. You know that they're just stupid little things that you look at and go, "Well."
How about when he fucks her without you present?
No, not anymore.
That doesn't bother you anymore. It used to.
It did in the beginning sometimes, but it's not an issue.
And what did Jerry say to you, right? What did Jerry say to you? Because I'm picturing what I would say to my girl. What did Jerry say to you when you did get jealous after he fucked her on the side, right? Damn, Dante, he might...
He is.
Holy shit. Mr. Jerry from Connecticut. So when he would say to you, all right, baby, look, I fucked her upstairs without you. What did he say to keep you there after he said, fuck you, I'm fucking her by myself?
Are you still there?
Yeah. What did he do to keep you when you went into a jealous kind of thing, whatever you went into? What did he do to say, what did he say to make you go, all right, okay, all right?
Basically, he just made sure he reassured me, you know, it was always, you know, I'm always here. You always go to sleep next to me every night. I'll always be there.
Do y'all all sleep in the same bed, too, or no? Do all three of y'all sleep in the same bed?
No, not normally. Sometimes on weekends.
Oh, the bitch sleeps on the couch or her other room?
No, she has her own room.
Oh, my God. And what about when he goes to the bathroom and he takes a peek into her pussy? On the way... Like, say... Wait a minute. Say you motherfuckers are spooning. This nigga gets up, goes to the bathroom, but he don't come back. He's in this bitch's room.
Her room is 2 floors away. Our bathroom and our bedroom are connected.
Fuck that. He pisses and then walks upstairs.
No. He doesn't do that. Sometimes he'd get up in the morning and go downstairs.
I'm digging the woman out.
Uh-huh.
I'm digging it. Hey, listen, I love you motherfuckers, but the woman has got to be there. The animal's there. So basically...
He's making it easy for her. He's creating an environment so that she can still maintain...
So he's not that, fucking up. So what he does is he knows what's going to make you kind of freak out and does not do that. He stays consistent with...
That's what he does.
So
that's
what
right.
is the context in which you guys start fucking, all three of you? What goes down?
You want me to answer that?
Yeah, you go ahead and answer that one.
Basically, it's
Saturday night or Friday night or Tuesday night,
party.
And we all want to start doing it. We just start doing it.
You start doing it. So basically, you never go tiptoe up to second bitch's room and get a little side or curl up with her?
No.
Well, every once in a while. But
sometimes, yeah. But most of the time, Patrice, you want to know the truth? The truth is my wife works at night, so she works downstairs. I'll bang the girlfriend, and then the wife comes to bed, and then I bang her.
Very good. You know what? Here's why he's a pimp. I'll tell you why he's a pimp.
It's keeping them all happy.
Hey, thanks. Hey, that was genius call. Listen, give one of these niggas your number if you can ever
you wanna talk to
come through. No, fuck that bitch. I'm gonna tell you why. I'm gonna tell you something.
She's not in it.
Here's the game. He has figured out how to treat that other. This is what we're gonna do. He's figured out how to treat the other bitch like the side bitch, and she stay in that place. He put her up in the attic, like the flowers in the attic. He slips cookies under the door, and she is like the gimp. He got her in a fucking trunk. and he pulls her out when he needs her. That is fucking genius. Jerry, you are a super genius, motherfucker. Get his number. Well, how much time we got left, dude?
About 2 minutes.
About 2 minutes? Oh, shit. Nice kid,
Eric.
Listen, I'm apologize to Mad. I'm apologize to fucking, who is it,
Eric,
Mike?
Eric is the one that started telling the story.
And Eric, nigga, we only got a little bit of time left. I apologize. Call back next week. I'm so sorry. Call back next show, whatever. I'm glad you niggas hung on. Everybody hang up because I ain't talking to nobody else. Fuck them. I'm gonna talk to you motherfuckers next week or whenever the fuck we coming back. You know this shit is inconsistent. We may be back. We may not. Today, Kathleen, we had to put Kathleen on punishment a little bit. She might be worried. She might not come back. She might even try to get a drop of dignity and say, I'm not coming back to get abused. But she'll be back. What else you doing, bitch? Nothing. You'll be back because you want to figure out how to not be abused because it's intriguing to you. You keep looking at my girl. She wants to tongue my girl so bad. I won't let it happen, bitch. How about that? Turn my mic back on, Eric. Turn my girl's mic back on, too. Now, it's not fine. Look at how you keep looking at her. You want my girl, you dirty bastard.
You want a kiss?
No.
Sweetie,
no,
give her a kiss on the cheek, would you?
But I don't want to get hit like I'm a man. My
look
neck
at her.
Hurts.
Oh, okay, that's
no.
True.
No. Yeah, what happened? No.
What?
Never mind.
We're on radio. Talk, baby. Look at her, all uneasy now.
She's recovering from a broken neck. I don't want to make out with her.
And it wasn't me, by the way. I didn't break the picture.
Okay, I didn't say you did.
You got any place you going to be? Any comedy you want to plug?
Yes, Stand Up New York, Saturday the 29th, 8 and 10 show.
Next
week, Saturday.
Stand Up New York is
right.
On 70. This 20, is New York.
It's 78th
and
Broadway.
78th Broadway.
The 29th?
Kathleen,
right,
Kathleen Roll will be at Stand Up New York, and you'll be there too, right?
And
there
Dante,
too. Dante will be
yeah.
down there. I got
absolutely.
Shows. The nigga, what's his name? Old Sissy wanted me to do it too, but I had to do something else. You know what I mean? But Kathleen, Dante will be down at the Stand Up New York next week, 78th and Broadway. And my girl will be with me. bitch will be in my car. The bitch will be in the side of my car. And I don't know. I don't want to tell you where she works. And hopefully I'll be back. But just listen out to when the show will be back on. All right. Thanks for listening. Take care.